Each year, approximately 600,000 people die of heart disease in the United States, one in every four deaths. It is the leading cause of deaths worldwide and costs the U.S. over $100 billion every year in healthcare, medications, and lost productivity. This year, a special group was formed to combat this devastating disease, ClimbCorps, the nation's first ever service corps dedicated to a public health issue. ClimbCorps is the work of Beyond DeLillo Associates, a marketing consulting firm in Wellesley. ClimbCorps members are deployed into the largest office buildings in Boston to repurpose all the stairwells in these buildings into fitness venues, running climb clubs throughout the week. Twice a year, the Corps members run Climb America weekends, in which the entire public can come into these buildings and participate in a climb to raise money and awareness for heart disease. Last month marked the first ever Climb America event, held at Boston's iconic Prudential Center. On this episode of Inside Wellesley, we tag along as ClimbCorps prepares for and runs the inaugural Climb America event. This is Inside Wellesley.
Heart disease kills more people than all cancers combined. So the time has come to have an event for the public to engage to make a difference on the issue that is killing more Americans than any other issue. The most underutilized real estate space in the United States are the millions of square feet of stairwells. What we're doing is we're staffing the stairwells. We're putting recent college grads who are trained in exercise physiology, trained in nutrition, trained in CPR, trained in every kind of way that you want to both be knowledgeable and safe, and then actually supervising the activity in the stairwell. Today we're going to have our final meeting before we launch the two events this weekend. And this is a time to really get everyone sort of psychologically prepared, happy with what's going to go on. And so we share with them, the details of how the day will go, what the setup will be, troubleshoot some of the final issues.
How are we, guys? We good? We're pretty good? Okay, so here we are. It's game time, right? So you want to hear a little bit from me about how do you have to think and what do you have to do? What's going to really happen at game time? First of all, none of us has ever been through this. Not me either. And I've probably been through more pledge events than anyone in the US. Never been through this. Never done a climb. All of us in brand new territory.
This is the first time that we as a group, will ever have done this type of event. And so there's always the normal trepidation when you're doing something for the first time. But we're pretty confident. We've got a good team in place. These are the core member themselves. They've been hired. They are recent college grads, and they've been hired because they're interested in public health, or interested in going to medical school, or interested in working in the nonprofit sector. For some of them, it's a gap year before medical school. Others, it's a stepping stone to other graduate schools and or careers, again, in health and in the nonprofit sector. The event on Sunday is a climathon. And so, people are familiar with walkathons and bikeathons, a similar premise. So rather than just walk, be it 3, 5, 6 miles, we climb a tall building. So on Sunday, we'll be climbing one of Boston's most iconic buildings, the Prudential Center. It's a 50-story building, and we're expecting almost 700 people in the event itself.
We are all going to bump into a couple little walls, trip over a couple logs, and at different times, wonder what's happening and is this okay and what do I have to do to fix it. Even though I think we've got a pretty good plan, I think we've been trained pretty well, we're as prepped as we can be. Again, we're all in it together, we're all smart, we're all can-do people. That's the way we're gonna play. Okay, I've got utmost confidence in this group to put on a great event.
ClimbCorps is, I think it's something that's pretty amazing, something that's taking an issue that's not talked about as often as it should be, considering it is the number one killer. And getting heart disease out there, getting people to know about it, and really getting the awareness out there, as well as getting people, actually motivating people to get fit and get involved with the cause.
We're basically all from different majors, different schools. There's people from California and everything, but we're all just trying to make a difference, I guess.
We will be advocates for the cause, advocates for people getting active, and awareness is one of our biggest missions through this whole project. So we'll be encouraging people to climb up the Pru and really spread awareness about heart disease.
I think we look great. I mean, I think we've got a great turnout this morning. People are excited. As you know, this is the inaugural Climb America event. And we have a great ambiance here. Energy in the crowd, people getting ready to make a difference for heart disease. A very strong turnout. It looks like between 700 and 1,000 people. We're very happy about that. We are in the workplace doing public health, running climb clubs in the building, giving lectures in the various companies, running lobby activities, and then twice a year we run Climb America events for the general public. All the ClimbCorps members are trained in CPR and AED.
Okay.
Plus we have two EMS personnel and an ambulance on site. There's a lot of people that can save you. But how about not croaking on me today?
Okay.
Right? Will you try not to? Good.
This is great. I mean, a ton of people here. It's very excited about it.
Good morning everyone. My name is Steve Biondolillo. I'm here representing Brigham and Women's Hospital's Cardiovascular Wellness Service. We are together, collectively, determined to repurpose all the stairwell in America into fitness venues. We're here to kick this program off today, Climb America. This is the first ever Climb America event, and I want you guys to give yourself a round of applause for participating in it.
Really embracing both the mission and the climb itself, which is ultimately what we wanted. There's a lot of energy, a lot of excitement. Some people are coming down a little winded, a little more tired than they expected, and some people are saying that was a breeze. But either way, it's such an accomplishment, and I think that we're really, really happy. And I think that we had a turnout around 11 or 1200, and so we couldn't have asked for any better. And I mean, for this being the inaugural year and the first time that we have this event, it was absolutely everything we could have hoped for.
The long-term goal is to become a national public health organization, to have ClimbCorps in no less than the top 25 cities in America, and probably more. There's actually already some interest internationally, but surely, you know, the initial plan was to get out to the 25 leading markets in the United States so that we'd have a core in each of those cities working in the most populated buildings and office complexes, bringing public health direct to the public. And how great would that be for all the major cities in the country to have a core operating, running climb clubs, repurposing all the stairwell in America and the fitness venues. And then beyond those big cities, we will have, like anyone else, a third-party program so that no matter where you are, even if we can't launch a core of young graduates, recent college graduates on the ground in your community, there'll still be activities and things you can do. It was wildly successful as far as I could see. The event was twice the national average in terms of participation. Just couldn't have been any more pleased. It was just a great atmosphere at the event.
Thank you.
Wellesley Cable Access Station is a nonprofit digital mass media access center serving the town of Wellesley, Massachusetts. We provide education and equipment for members of the Wellesley community that are interested in digital audio video production and distribution. We also coordinate television coverage of local events and oversee two local television channels in Wellesley. In the past months, the Wellesley Cable Access Station has undergone a change. With a new name and a revamped website, the Wellesley Cable Access Station is now the Wellesley Media Corporation. We are now broadcast on two channels, the Wellesley Community Channel and the Government Channel. Our live news shows, Wellesley sports games, events in town, and our original programming are aired on the Wellesley Community Channel. All municipal-related meetings are broadcast on our additional Government Channel. With the newly designed website, both of our channels can be accessed online. Whether you want to watch live streaming video from our channels, our award-winning original programming, or catch an event from last week on demand, our website provides you with access to what you need. The Wellesley Media Corporation has also joined the social media world with a brand new Facebook page and Twitter account. You'll get updates from the channel and have an opportunity to give us feedback as well. Tune in for updates on live event coverage and other programming, classes, and job posting. Wellesley Media Corporation welcomes community involvement. Our set is open to any local resident who would like to produce a show.
I mean, it's good training ground. It's a good place to, you know, to get to know what you want to do. And I mean, I had no idea what was when I came in here, and I've learned a lot. I've learned a ton since then.
Current programs such as Artbeat, Health Source, and Wellesley Open House are all produced by Wellesley residents. Here at WMC, we welcome new ideas and are here to guide you through the process. We provide the hands-on training and classes so that you can gain the experience you need to produce your own show.
What a great resource we've got here in Wellesley. I see kids coming through doing things. I see other adults coming through doing things. And it's a very cooperative environment to help people learn how to produce and create video.
We also provide internship opportunities and scholarships to those who demonstrate a long-term commitment to the station.
The opener.
Yeah, the opening, and then we're going to do the kitchen tips, and the play, and then we'll be set.
I've been working here for the last 4 years of my high school experience, and I absolutely love working here, and it's a really great place to come and volunteer.
If you would like to learn more about the Wellesley Media Corporation, visit us at www.wellesleymedia.org or stop by and visit us in person at 37 Walnut Street, Suite 110 in Wellesley. You can also friend us at facebook.com/Wellesley Media and follow us on Twitter at Wellesley_media.